Black Lives Matter!
This is injustice!
This is terrible! What is society doing?
Sir, we'll get through this.
Order, order, the court is in session.
Case number 433, UL versus Robinson. On the rape of Mayela UL, Mr. Gilmer, you're up first.
Thank you, Judge Taylor. I'm here representing on behalf of the Ewells. This is about justice, justice for all women. Mr. Bob Ewell, could you please take the stand? Go.
Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, but nothing but the truth? So help you God.
I do. All right, Mr. Ewell, did you see the defendant having sexual intercourse with your daughter?
Yes, I did.
Explain what you witnessed.
In our living room, it looked like there was a fight. The black man was all over my daughter.
Ooh. And what did you do?
I tried to take a video, my flash was on, and at that moment, he took off running, like his kind does. And after that, I was trying to chase after him, but I was too distracted by my yellow on the ground. And I called the cops, but it was too late, and my phone proved nothing.
Then what happened?
Just a minute, Bob. May I ask a question?
Sure. What is it?
Thank you, Mr. Yule. How often do you consume alcohol at home?
It's my kind of medicine, but I wasn't drunk when I saw what I saw.
Okay, Bob. You heard the sheriff's testimony. Her right eye was blackened. Could you please catch this water bottle for me?
Objection.
Overruled.
My shoulder kind of hurts, but I'll do anything for you.
Here's the bottle.
He's left-handed?
What's me being left-handed got to do with anything? I saw what I saw, and that doesn't change the fact that I saw that day.
Boo! Oh, racist!
Racist! Racist!
That's all, Your Honor.
We will be taking a 5-minute recess.
Court is back in session.
What happened on the night of the alleged attack?
Well, it started with me needing help moving a shelf to another room. So I saw him and I called him in to help me.
What happened next?
He was moving into the other room and all the kids were like being crazy and everything. And it just kind of got out of control. And the next thing I knew, I was in the hospital.
Mrs. Mayela, what is your level of schooling?
Dropped out when I was 12.
How many friends do you have?
None, really.
Did you know Tom Robinson before all this?
Yeah, I've known him from the visits that I take to the marijuana dispensary.
How would you say he's always acted towards you?
He's a nice man. He's helped me around the house before.
Does your father know Tom's helped around the house?
No.
Do you love your father?
Huh?
Is he good to you? Is he easy to get along with?
He is, except when he's good.
Except when he's drinking. Does he need you?
Answer the question.
No.
Okay, Mrs. Mayela. Let's get back to the case. As you know, Tom works on the farm. What's his family? Tom has a completely clean record. Good citizen. No parking tickets, rent, taxes, paid on time. You're saying you don't remember what happened after your siblings were running around?
I heard yelling.
By whom?
I think my father.
Hold on one. Tom Robinson, can you do me a favor? Can you catch this for me, sir? Now with your other hand?
I can't.
Why not?
You see, when I was 11 years old and I was working in a pressing factory, the press slammed on my left hand and now I do not have a left hand.
Miss Mayela, did that man, your friend, hit you?
I don't know.
Did your father attack you?
I'm done.
Miss Mayela! Tom Robinson, may you please take a stand.
Tom, may you please tell the jury what happened that night?
Yeah, so I was driving home from the farm as I do every night and every morning. And I was working till late that night. And I was waiting at a red light when I saw the Ewell's house, and I saw a bunch of kids running around upstairs and Myella bringing boxes through the front door. And that was when she saw me and asked me for help.
What happened next, Tom?
I parked my car and ran across the street, and I knew her father wasn't the nicest of fellows, but I wanted to help her out with whatever she needed help with quickly. So she needed help with fixing her TV and moving her bed on the other side of the room. And while I was moving my bed, there was some yelling, and it actually startled me.
Like Mr. Ewell was yelling?
I think so. I didn't hear his voice until today.
Could you please explain what happened after the yelling?
So I got scared. I saw a flash, it about blinded me, and I dropped the bed frame. I fell back and landed on my yellow, and I heard, "Get out of here, you goddamn Negro." So I ran.
So you didn't rape my yellow, Yule?
No, sir.
Thank you, Tom. You may go sit down. Bob Yule, could you take the stand?
Sure.
Thank you. Hello, Mr. Bob Yule. If I may ask, how long ago did your wife die?
About 4 years ago, after my youngest daughter, Skylar, was born.
Isn't the youngest kid named Adam? Isn't he 3 years old?
What are you accusing me of?
Not accusing, just asking. Who is the mother of Adam?
What kind of question is that?
Answer the question.
He's my eldest kid. He's not even mine. You don't even look like me.
You're still related, idiot.
Bob, are you the father of Adam?
No.
Objection. Could I have the floor?
No. Atticus, go on.
You're lying under an oath. It's a shame. It could have been so much easier if you just admitted you used your left hand to smack Myella. Just admit that you saw him in your house, got scared, and used everything in your possible abilities to say that he raped her. You are the rapist, not Tom.
No, I'm not.
You are a disgrace.
He's getting away.
You're under arrest.
Order, order. The jury has made a decision. The jury finds the defendant Tom Robinson innocent and Bob Ewell charged with assault.
I got the horses in the bag. The horse stock is attached.